This contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing in the ring at this time, Paul Bearer from
6 foot
Dallas,
nine or ten,
weighing 300 pounds, with Undertaker.
What a dangerous individual is he ever! And he's agile, and he's quick, and you can pound on him, and he knows what he's doing in that ring, and he doesn't care. And has formaldehyde running through his veins. I wouldn't doubt it. I shook his hand once, you know, months ago. Hand's ice cold. How can you keep your hand ice cold when you're in a warm building? Guy's not real. The guy is not real. Oh, here he comes! The resident dummy!
Williams Falls, New York, weighing 280
pounds. Look at the ovation and the reception here for Hacksaw Jim Duggan! Undertaker's not impressed. Look at him. He is not impressed with that 2x4 carry cockeye. Well, I found her part. Talking about you. I have barely seldom seen Brain on any occasion. Facial expression on the Undertaker. Very he's intense. Look at him. I'll tell you what, this Hacksaw, he'll get your attention. Whoa, just like that. But he didn't go down. Watch it. Watch how much punishment he can take. Well, you're looking at two big super 300-pounders here that are also going to be in the big battle royal.
20 man over the top.
Whoa! Look at that. Came right down on his feet. What agility, what balance.
He's standing on his feet. It didn't even faze him.
I think the little upside down ride.
Got his attention, maybe. Didn't faze him. The man never even breathes heavy. You never see him try to catch a breath. The man is not real. Look at him.
You believe this, Brain? Here we are in Royal Albert Hall. And Hacksaw Jim Duggan has got him chanting USA.
Whoa! What a move!
What's in the urn? You were supposed to find this out.
Well, I was asked not to tell, so I can't. I can't
go back on my word. You're a liar. You don't have a clue what's in there.
I can't go back on my word. Yeah. It's not that kind
of
guy.
Word isn't any good. I got news for you. You'll find that out tomorrow.
Look at that.
Whoa. Blatant chokehold. Come on, ref, what are you waiting for?
Grave Digger paws around his neck and chokes. You know, this Undertaker brings a whole new meaning to the name Jack the Ripper. I can just see him going across the rooftop about 1 or 2 in the morning. People would move out of the neighborhood. I'm telling you, this man is scary. He is dangerous.
Nightmare City is what it's all about. Hacksaw trying to get something going for himself, but so far it's been a little one-sided.
Hacksaw's up on his feet, though. He's too dumb to know when he's had enough. Another big right.
Not too much behind those shots, though.
He's taking a lot out of Duggan. He's been choking on him since the bell rang. Duggan's a real, real tough guy. But this Undertaker, he is not human, Monsoon.
Still puts his pants on one leg at a time, Brain.
I doubt it.
You doubt it, huh?
I doubt it. He may never take them off. How do you know? Why would he put them on? The man's not human. He has a grayish cast to his body.
Be interesting, Brain, to see.
Look at that.
What happens later on when the Undertaker slaps that same choke move onto Rick Flair at the Battle Royal?
It could happen. It could happen. He's big enough to pick Ric Flair up and anybody else up and just throw
him
out.
Look at this agility here.
Watch this.
All the way to the top rope, walking right down it. That's 320-something pounds, folks.
Wow. That is agility. Can you see him going across the rooftops over in the east end of London here? Him and Jack the Ripper just out having a good time going house to house.
Will you stop?
I'm trying to picture this in my mind. You know, a lot of history.
In what mind?
Don't yell at me.
Can't believe that Hacksaw's still in there.
Hacksaw does have a lot of fight in him.
Most of it's been knocked out of him.
You know, that urn has some significant meaning. When the Undertaker's taking over, when he's leading the match, when he's got everything going his way, he occasionally will look over to Paul Bearer and take a glimpse of that urn. Look, he's got the urn up in the air now. Look at this.
Lift job right out of the corner. Inverted atomic drop, perhaps. Yes.
Doesn't faze him.
Oh, yes, he felt that, Brain.
He felt it, but it doesn't faze him.
Hacksaw beat him to the punch there twice, three times.
Driving him right back into the corner.
He could be making the same mistake that The Undertaker made only a few moments ago.
He's gonna do any damage, he better do it now. Where's he going now?
Going after that you-know-what disturber out there. That's why he's got Paul Bearer, he's got the 2x4 that belongs to Hacksaw.
Here comes The Undertaker. Ooh, right in the back of the neck.
See, now, to me, that's automatic disqualification, man.
Yeah, but to you, it don't mean
when
that.
When you distract somebody like that, when you deliberately taunt someone, oh, yeah. That's unfair play. Oh,
American tradition,
it's
taunt
not
people.
Yes,
Look at this. Look at that height. Look at the altitude he got. Phenomenal.
There's that urn sticking in there again.
Looked to me like he was 6 feet over the top rope when he leaped.
Very methodical, like a robot at times.
As opposed to 6 feet under.
He wants the urn. What's that tattoo he's got there, Dan?
It's the Grim Reaper. Gonna be grave consequences for Duggan, if you know what I mean.
Oh! 2x4, it might be the equalizer.
That's it, but he didn't go down. He did not go down. Duggan hit him with a 2x4. Look at that.
The winner of this bout resulting from a disqualification.
Look at that, Monsoon.
Undertaker.
I'm getting out of here.
This should have been a disqualification a long time ago, and the winner should have been Hacksaw.
There's something. Something's going down here now. Here he comes. He's going to hit him with the board again.
Not over yet.
One.
He knocked The Undertaker over the top rope and down. But once again, he landed on his feet.
He draws power from that urn. Something in that urn keeps him alive. Something is alive in that urn. His life is in that urn. His future is in that urn.
Hard-fought victory. Hacksaw doesn't have anything to be ashamed about here. Right now, let's take you back in the locker room area. B.G. Milkerlin with the hot rod.
Well, Roddy Piper, it has been a very exciting first half of the Battle Royal here at Royal Albert Hall. I understand you spent a little time around London today, getting out and mixing and mingling.
I tell you, I'm prouder than Punch to be at the Royal Albert Hall. I wish I had some relatives so they could be proud of me, Matt. I've never been in company this good before. course, I figured if they let Bobby the Brain Heenan in, then I could come in. I figured that was okay. Heenan, I've been listening to you. You lie more than the government does. And one more time, you call this a skirt, baby, I'm going to come up there and slap you so long your hair's going to go back to its natural color. And as for you, Mr. Ric Flair, the real world champion, if you believe that, you believe there's going to be a boy George Jr. Let me tell you something, real world champion, you feather-wearing freak. Let me tell you something. Not one time have I backed down from no one. Battle Royal, you should see these guys back there. 20 guys, they're gnawing on the walls. They're gnawing on each other. Oh, it's going to be a wonderful time. What I'm going to do, I'm going to get my hands on Flair, going to finish up the Battle Royal. Then you know what I'm going to do? What? I'm going to get that football player, Gaza, going to take him to the disco, show him how to ring a few bells. Fire!
Well, actually, I thank you very much, Roddy Piper. I'm going to be spending time about 4 p.m. tomorrow afternoon for a little high tea over with the Queen Mother. Perhaps you could join me for that. Mean Gene Okerlund along with the Mouth of the South, Jimmy Hart, Typhoon. Of course, this is the Royal Samovar Trophy. Sterling silver that is going to be awarded tonight to somebody in that battle royal. The winner gets the silver in this case, Jimmy Hart.
You know, the Hart organization, we have 5 chances to win that battle royal. We have the Nasty Boys, the Mountie, the Earthquake, and the Typhoon, Daddy.
You got a lot of ball, a lot of nerve talking to me like that. Now, Typhoon, there are no... There are no friends, there are no foes, actually, and it's every man for himself at a battle royal. You've been in a number yourself. I don't know what just hypothetically would happen if at the end of the battle royal it would end up with both you and Earthquake in that ring.
First of all, Mean Gene, that's none of your business. And secondly, if it was to come down to that, that's up to the Typhoon and the Earthquake to judge the outcome. And that's it.
Well, wait a minute, I didn't get much
of that. Case closed.
What? That's an inconclusive answer, Jimmy Hart. This guy's got to give...
That's the only answer you're going to get. You hear, Mean Gene?
Come on, Typhoon. Let's go zip it up, Mean Gene. Come on,
thank
baby.
You very much, we're gentlemen. Ready, I'm just trying to explain a hypothetical situation. It could happen that very close friends end up being the final two men in the ring at the conclusion of a battle royal. What would happen then? Who knows? Let's get down to business. The World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions are going to be defending the Legion of Doom tonight to meet Power and Glory, Hercules, and, of course, his partner, Paul Roma.
You know, that's right, Gene. You know, they thought they could run from us. They thought they could hide, but they can't hide from us. They traveled all the way to London, but we're here, aren't we, Power? What are we going to do to them? Tell them.
To the other side. We have no limits, Legion of Doom. There's nothing we won't do. We've come halfway around the world to do battle with you in the Royal Albert Hall. This is going to be your downfall. You're going to be beaten, defeating men, laying in the middle of the ring. 1, 2, 3.
You know, did you get that, Gene?
Yeah, I get it. Gentlemen, I should point out one thing. When you have an opportunity to meet the Legion of Doom for the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Championship belts, if you should fail, it could be a long time or a cold day somewhere.
What are you talking about, failure? We are not failure. Why do you think we're called the Power and the Glory? Read it right there. Does that say failure? It says winner on it. And that's what we are. We're a winning team.
You got it. And that's it. Legion of Doom, you're in a lot of trouble.
I thank you very much, Paul Roma, and of course his partner Hercules. Collectively, they are Power and Glory. A match that the entire United Kingdom is going to be watching very shortly pits these two men up against the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions. I'm here with the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions. They are Hawk and Animal, the Legion of Doom. I'm certain you heard the comments earlier on from the men that are going to be challenging you tonight for these titles, Power and Glory, Paul Roma, and the mighty Hercules, Animal.
That's right, Gene. Hulk and I are back there watching the monitor, and we couldn't help overhearing you two little geeks. You tell us we don't deserve to be champions. You tell us you're going to show us where the power and who is the glory. How do you think we got to be world champions? By beating nobodies? We've beaten the best that the World Wrestling Federation has to offer, and we're going to be champions for a long, long time. Right, Hawk?
What about it, Hawk?
Swelling of the fluid sac surrounding.
surrounding the brain, contusions, inner bleeding. These are the things that our dreams are made of, power and glory. And you'll soon be renamed Sour and Gory, because when we get done with you, your mother won't accept the looks that you have been thrown about the ring from one end to the other right here in London.
You know, gentlemen, aside from your title defense, I don't know if I, with the magnitude of this title defense, I don't know if I should touch on it, but it's conceivable the two of you are going to be involved in the gigantic battle royal at the end of the night. Now, I tried to ask a couple of people earlier on what would happen, say, for instance, if Hawk and Animal, if you were to be the final two men in the ring at the end of the battle royal, how would things shake up?
Just one way to sum that up, Mean Gene. You see, Gene, Hawk and I are, since we were little punk kids in Chicago, we've been against the odds all our life. And we've proven, just the way a lot of people out there have proven, that you can be something. And now, we're the WWF World Tag Team Champions. And after we beat you, Power and Glory, we're coming after that battle royal. Because there's nothing better than the Legion of Doom lights is a good gang fight. Right, Hawk?
Thank you very much, gentlemen. They are the Legion of Doom, Animal, and Hawk. Their title defense tonight is against Power and Glory, and it all happens here at Royal Albert Hall. Speaking of that, let's get back outside to my close friends and colleagues, the Weasel and you, Gorilla Monsoon. Well, really.
What an outstanding night of wrestling so far here at Royal Albert Hall, and still to come. Hold on. Who are you talking to?
You dumb lady.
What are you talking about? Will you pay attention?
I said you ought to go home to your mommy.
We got a tag team title defense still to come here. Legion of Doom putting their belts on the line against Power and Glory, and the unprecedented 20-man over-the-top battle royal. You got it right, folks. The Weasel. Let's take you down to Mel Phillips, our ring announcer. Here we go.
The following is a tag team attraction scheduled for one fall, and it is for the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Championship. Now making their way to the ring area, the challengers, at a combined weight of 508 pounds, Power and Glory.
Perfection!
Golden opportunity here in the United Kingdom for Herc and Power and Glory. Title on the line.
Legion of Doom.
Their opponents from Chicago, Illinois, at a combined weight of 572 pounds, the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions, Hawk and Animal, the Legion of Doom.
There's a future Legion of Doomer there. Tag team belts up for grabs.
This is for the title on the line, right here in jolly old London, England.
Unprecedented here in Royal Albert Hall, World Wrestling Federation, tag team belts on the line.
Well, they may be making a mistake. I don't know if Legion of Doom knows enough about Power and Glory.
Well, I do.
And it's Romeo Roma, not Herc and Jerk.
Oh, I like Herc and Jerk. It's short, to the point.
And you think it says it all?
It certainly does. Talk about powerhouses. Four of them in there. Each looking to show their wares, Brad.
You know, it's harder to win a title than to keep it.
You've got that right. Only way you can lose it is on a pinfall or submission. Anything else doesn't count. You can lose the match and go home with the short end of the purse money, but you still go home with the gold.
I believe you can pin Legion of Doom. I don't think they'll give up.
So now there's only one way.
That's right. And I think the skill and finesse that Power and Glory have.
What skill and finesse?
Stick around and see. I was in the dressing room earlier, and Herc came up to me and said, "Bobby, tonight, we'll go out on a town, it's on me, because you're going to be riding in style with the new World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions." I never saw him more confident before.
Who was that?
Romeo told me that, and Hercules.
Hercules.
Hercules, I mean, you know what I mean.
guy you sold down the river.
It's not important.
No.
He patched everything up.
I'm sure, yeah.
He realized that he made a mistake.
Yeah.
Okay, it's okay.
Sure.
Don't do that, Romeo.
He's pain. He will. He's going to do it. Watch. Vanity will get the best of him. Not too clever.
I wouldn't do it.
What are they talking? What are they saying?
I can't quite make it out, Frank.
Everybody talks funny over here.
So they all got a toothache.
They think you talk funny.
No, they don't.
You do.
No, I don't. I use the Queen's English.
Yeah. Hey, Romeo Roma, no slouching that upper body power.
Uh-uh, not at all.
But,
hey, he came out on top on that one.
Yeah, well, he used a few
does it matter?
Unorthodox things.
Does it matter?
Whoa! Drop kick and a beauty!
Hawk goes right out after. He doesn't care about Hercules out there. These guys are fighters.
Street fighters, the most dangerous kind. Cardinal mistake made by Romeo. Put it and paid royally for it. Snapmare.
Well, they're a tough team to beat. There's no doubt about it. Are they in the 20-man battle royal?
Absolutely.
I didn't know that.
You're supposed to know everything.
Wait a minute. The World Wrestling Federation tag team champions are going to be in there?
That's correct.
Wow.
They might get a chance to pound down Ric Flair.
Or natural disasters might take them out easier. Hot Rod won't show up.
Would you like to put your money where your mouth is?
Well, not betting, man. You'd welch out on it.
Weasel? Did I hear you say weasel?
I said you'd welch out on a bet. Hercules has him going now.
Irish whip. Oh, short one, but whoa.
Boy, how things can change.
Animal came right out of that corner with a short clothesline and sort of cleaned his clock for him.
Big Ben would never ring like that.
In addition to their tremendous size and strength, they've also got speed, agility, and continuity. That's why they're the champions.
Well, they've been together so long. They've been so many fights, so many battles over the years, in and out of the ring. They fight each other half the time. They just like to fight.
Nice inverted atomic drop there by Herc.
You don't have haircuts like that. And without having a bad disposition.
Or you're going to the chair.
Or going to the chair, yeah.
Oh, look at this.
It won't bother Hercules.
You'll have a headache.
Last call.
He's looking for the corner. He wants a tag.
Whoa!
Romeo not in any big hurry to get back in there.
Smart tag team. Take his time. Let the other team think maybe you don't want in. Maybe you're a coward.
You don't.
Well, I don't know that. He's in, isn't he?
Yeah, he is.
It's such a mind game when you're in there. Well, I was always so successful.
Because of playing my mind games.
Come on,
you were successful.
Oh, very successful. Now they're keeping the man in the corner. Cutting off the ring. Don't let him out. Don't take him out of there, Roma. Keep him in there. You got to pound on Hawk. You got to clip his wings.
Pile driver, yes!
Hawk, the bird of prey. He's up on his seat.
Hawk said, was that my wake-up call?
Roma, you better be praying to get out of there now.
Look at this. Press slam coming up. Look how long he held it.
Whoa! Are they powerful?
What a classic.
Picture this, Monsoon. In the big battle royal coming in 20 men, what if they press guys over their head like that and throw them to the floor? Somebody's going to the hospital tonight.
Wouldn't surprise me.
Hawks up on top.
One of the most dangerous.
Whoa!
Nice move there by Romeo.
He went right out of the ring.
20-man battle royal. That's 40 arms and legs flailing around at the same time. Some guys could have their career terminated here. Sprawled out on the concrete. One half of the Legion of Doom.
You know, Animal never comes to help Hawk. He never comes to help Animal. They just survive on their own. Maybe that's what makes them such a great team.
Watch this.
Oh. Well, in the words of a good friend of mine, back, 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 gone.
Come on, Hawk!
What? His back may be gone after that move, Brain.
You bet. Starting to chant Hawk. Full of birds in a half an hour. You know, Alfred Hitchcock lived just down the street. Some dump.
You can imagine, Brain, what this 120-year-old facility has seen over the years, but nothing like the likes of the World Wrestling Federation and what it can deliver.
That's right. They have tractor pulls in here.
Highly unlikely.
Where do they put the ice for hockey?
Will you stop? Why don't you ask the Queen all that tomorrow?
I'm gonna be chewing the fat with her.
Leave me alone.
Oh!
Hawk, I rear-ended. This match has been a lot closer so far than I thought it was gonna be.
No, I knew it would be like this. I imagine, matter of fact, I thought Power and Glory would be ahead on points now.
Put the brakes on!
Points don't matter, Brain.
Whoa!
Shoulder block.
Did he nail him? Animal's in control now.
On the rampage. Drop kick, a standing one at that.
And the guy goes over 300 pounds, right?
Absolutely.
Ooh.
Oh, yes. Oh!
It's over.
It would have been had not Hercules been there to make the save.
Shows great determination. Shows you how much they want it. Roma's back on his feet. He slams Animal. That shows you what great shape Roma's in. Roma's going up.
What a gutsy kid.
Nail him. Oh, no.
Beautiful high cross body.
That's all right.
Power slam. And just like that, it's a successful title defense.
The winners of this bout and still World Wrestling Federation. Tag Team Champions, the Legion of Doom!
I want to see more of that.
Legion of Doom successfully defending their title here in the United Kingdom for the first time. And a standing ovation.
They're on their feet.
Deservedly so. Let's go back and take a look at some of that tremendous action.
Look at Roma goes to the top rope and leaps on Hawk. There's a 250-pound man. He catches and drives right into the mat, cinches him up. The referee's in position. There's your World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champion.
Woo! Right now, we're going to take you back to our interview area. Me, Gene Okerlund, is with Davey Boy Smith. Here we go.
Talk about your action. You're seeing it all tonight. We're back on terra firma, home ground, if you will, for my guest at this time. Just around a corner up north in Manchester, England, the British Bulldog, Davey Boy Smith. Welcome back to the UK.
That's right. I'm excited, Mean Gene. The British Bulldog's at home. And what did we say to each other, Mean Gene, on the flight over here when we landed in London Airport? I said, I smell something, Mean Gene. I said, I smell victory. The British Bulldog smells victory in his hometown. He smells victory wrestling the Barbarian coming up pretty soon. And then, Mean Gene, I smell victory in that 20-man battle royal. Earthquake, typhoon. There's an old saying in England, the bigger they are, the harder they fall. And you will fall to the feet of the British Bulldog right here in the Royal Albert Hall.
Ladies and gentlemen, for this next contest, it gives me very great pleasure to introduce to you the incomparable, welcome home, Lord Alfred Hayes.
Thank you, Mel. Thank you very much. Thank you, everybody. This next contest is scheduled for 1-4. Making his way very shortly to the ring area from parts unknown at 300 pounds, the Barbarian.
The real Lord of the World Wrestling Federation, His Lordship Alfred Hayes.
He can be a lord, I can be a lord. You want to be a lord? Lord Banana. Be good for you.
The antlered one making his way down.
The Earl. I used to manage the Barbarian. I know what he's capable of doing.
Took him for every dime he made. He
did not. Don't start spreading that.
It's all he's got left is those
antlers. And now, it is my privilege to introduce, from Goldburn, Lancashire, a 19 stone.
Similar to the ovation you got when you entered the building tonight.
Well, they were standing and applauding and screaming. You know, I'm a bigger hit here. When I landed at the airport this morning, you realize there were more women there screaming than when the Beatles landed at LaGuardia, New York?
Would you be serious?
And that was because they knew that I knew where the real world champion was living. What hotel he was at. I'm telling you. Heenan Mania's running wild here.
Bulldog is the chant from this capacity crowd.
Now, he's a powerful man, the Bulldog. There's no doubt about that.
So is the Barbarian.
Is he ever.
Woo.
Look at that. Like two freight trains colliding. 410 to Manchester and the 315 to parts unknown. Boom!
Seizing the moment here.
You know, he's a disgrace to the country, you know.
Who is?
The Bulldog.
He is not.
The rumor I get.
Jeez.
Ooh. Uh-oh.
About a half step too late on that. Baby Boy had him measured.
What power these two have. And the agility of the Bulldog. You gotta give him credit. He's in great shape. He's an agile athlete.
I bless all you, Mr. Wilman.
But there's a violent man right there.
I bless all him what the wrestling's all about.
Are we going to get a translation? Are we going to have some English subtitles on what the Barbarian had to say?
Oh, well, what he said basically is English meat tastes real neat.
Oh.
It's an old saying in his village.
Didn't get a whole lot of meat when he was working for you, did he?
They needed a head.
Nice arm ringer by Davey.
Strict vegetable. Pretty evenly matched, aren't they, inside?
Yes, they are.
I think the Barbarian's got about a 4.5-pound advantage on him, and he's a little bigger, about 2 inches taller.
But guess who's a whole lot thicker?
Move.
And quicker.
Sit down, sit down, sit down. Just sit down. Just sit down. Drop that fur. Sit down.
Ooh. Nobody home on that one.
But he couldn't get him down, could he?
No, he couldn't.
Great, tough, agile British Bulldog. could not turn the Barbarian over.
Hey, not an easy move. If you don't catch that move with the initial momentum, most times you can forget it.
Well, Bulldog, forget it.
But one move does not a match make, Frank.
It's a catchy song title.
Ooh. Put his head down.
Whoa.
Oh, right through the legs. Andrade, a deep one and a beauty.
Did I detect a smidgen of Shakespeare come out of you?
From who?
You.
No.
You just said, what a light through Chandra break.
I did not say anything like that.
Sound that way to me.
What do you know about Shakespeare?
Only Shakespeare, number 43, tight end, Miami Dolphins.
That's what I figured. Absolutely nothing.
University of Grambling, 1967.
You'll be grambling before we're done here.
What a player, boy. Couldn't play real well, but he gave great interviews.
Will you stop?
You asked me.
Why do you think Davey Boy is doing that to his hair now, Frank?
I think the state does it to him.
There goes the chant once again.
I think it's easier when the health department checks for wood ticks.
Oh.
He wants to look stupid. You're accomplishing it. You're doing a great job, Bulldog.
You know, I thought Davey Boy was going to come out here and make short work of the Barbarian.
No way.
In hopes of not expending too much energy because he knows that that Battle Royal is still to come. But it certainly does appear that way, doesn't it?
Well, you know, I'll tell you who might have the advantage. The people who wrestled earlier.
Earlier
have a little
on,
more
yes.
time to recuperate.
No question.
Excuse me. Director, can you hear me okay now?
The director can hear me.
Well, when I recite some Shakespeare, I want to make sure they get it good.
Struggling to stay in this one. British Bulldog, Davey Boy Smith.
Woof, woof.
I'm sure his mom and dad are here.
They are?
I'm sure they are.
Is there a mess on the floor someplace?
Why do I even bother? Listen to that chant. Bulldog. What support here for the British Bulldog, and rightfully so. Tremendous athlete. A real testament to what the United Kingdom is all about.
I can chant too, you know.
Barbarian! Yeah, but the only problem is no one is chanting with you.
Doesn't matter. He who chants by himself chants alone.
Yeah. Boy, I thought his lordship, Alfred Hayes, really looked good, didn't you, Brian?
For a guy that was here on the opening of the Royal Albert Hall.
Will you be serious? He was. I'm sure that won't bother him in the least.
Not the first nosebleed he's had, and won't be the last. But who gave it to him? The Barbarian. So all you humanoids can chant bulldog, bullfrog, whatever you want all day long. The Barbarian gave him a nosebleed, and he's got the Bulldog down right now. See, when you do something bad with the Barbarian, he does what you're supposed to do to a dog. You rub its nose in it.
I suppose you've never had your nose rubbed in it.
Never done anything wrong.
Davey Boy finally gets to his feet. In hopes of alleviating some of that downward pressure.
He certainly doesn't want to lose at home, Monsoon. Oh, but he may be losing. You come home, you're at the Royal Albert Hall. You want to go out for that Battle Royal. You'd love to win that. But first, you got to win this one. And I don't think he's going to get by this one. And with that bloody nose, if his nose is broke, he won't even be out for the Battle Royal, I bet. Look at this, pile driver. Hook up the leash and take him for a walk. He's done.
What do you think that Samovar trophy would look like on the mantle at home of the British Bulldog? Or on the park bench, if it should happen to fall into the hands of the Barbarian.
Are you insinuating this gentleman sleeps in the park?
You got it.
He does like air.
I know that.
Fresh air.
And attacks everything that comes by.
Not in the park. Mostly wood. He likes wooded areas.
Second turnbuckle on the inside.
Drop
Barbarian
it
about to drop it. Oh! He waited a little bit too long.
They're coming alive here.
They're getting ready. Davey Boy smells victory. Got his second win.
Just like that, one mistake and the pendulum has swung.
Whoa!
Over the top into the steel rail. He's going out after him.
Oh, rams him head first into the steel barricade.
Oh, isn't that nice? Right in the old gabanza.
You're not going to hurt the Barbarian by ramming his head into anything.
No, not at all. Waffle him, waffle him.
Oh, now see that? He took right on the bicep. That was tremendous pain for him.
But doesn't seem to faze him.
He Irish is that tough now by Davey Boy. Clothesline finds the mark. You won't get
kick out, kick out, kick out.
Don't get the Barbarian
kick out
like that. You can't nonchalantly
cover
the Barbarian and beat him.
And you can't just knock him down a couple times and think that's it.
Suplex coming up. High vertical.
Look how long he's holding him.
Oh! Now he's right for the pickings.
He won't get him, though. Come on, come on.
Once again,
I know him, I know him. But I know the Barbarian. He's got fight in him. He's got fight. He was hit by a car once, chased the car down, ripped the tires off, and the driver passed out. That's the kind of tough guy he is. He don't mind getting hit by a car.
Sick. You are a sick person.
Ooh, oh, listen to that.
Followed him in, but too late. Oh, look at this. He's got him up.
One-handed.
He's got him up with that patented power slam move. There it is.
Kick out one. Come on,
not
come on.
Not this time. Not this time.
Just about over. We're minutes away from the Battle Royal.
You know, the Nasty Boys, baby, they're halfway there. They took care of the Rockers, and things are going to get real nasty in the Battle Royal. Right, boys?
Yeah, that's right, Jimmy. Listen, Gene, when has there been a more tragic event happening in Europe than the Nasty Boys coming to town? Never. Oh, there's been a plague here and there. Some cat named Adolf raised a little hell around here, but never nothing like the Nasties coming to town. We've proved it with the Rockers. Now it's time for the Battle Royal. How about it, Knobs? Oh, what a night on this European Rampage Tour. Everybody but everybody is going to feel the wrath of the Nasty Boys. Rockers, you have already felt it. Now it's for everybody else, like Roddy Piper, the British Bulldogs, the LOD. There's two of us out there, and we're working like a team. It's time to get nasty, and we're going out there to destroy everybody.
All right, it's going to be every man for himself in the gigantic 20-man Battle Royal coming up next right here.
Gorilla Monsoon, along with the Brain, Bobby the Brain Heenan, welcoming his lordship, Alfred Hayes, here to the broadcast booth. Right at home, your lordship, aren't you?
Thank you, Gorilla, absolutely. My environment here. What is that?
Monsoon. What is it? Right now, let's go down to Mel Phillips and get things going with the Battle Royal.
Ladies and gentlemen, This contest is scheduled for one fall. This will be the 20-man over-the-top rope battle royal.
This is what I've been waiting for.
Before introducing the principles in this contest, the rules are quite simple. By whatever means necessary, a man must be thrown over the top rope, making contact with the floor on the outside. This is the process of elimination. This process continues until one man remains in the ring. This lone survivor is declared the winner of this royal match. And as a reward for his effort, is to be presented the Royal Samovar. Now the participants. Introducing first, from Denton, Texas, weighing 254 pounds, the Texas Tornado, Kerry Von Erich.
Well, we're just about to get underway. 20 of the top stars here in the World Wrestling Federation vying for that coveted. What is that?
It's a samovar. It's a Russian tea urn. But it's solid silver.
Has that been around ever since Queen Victoria's time? Or?
I believe it may have been around actually before the birth of Queen Victoria.
Oh. Only in the World Wrestling Federation could you get 20
and
guys
next,
fighting for a teapot.
Making their way to the ring area.
Oh, I'm sorry about that.
At a combined weight.
That, of course, is the brain, Bobby Heenan.
140 pounds. The natural disasters. Earthquake.
And
typhoon.
I'm going to before we're done here.
Yes, absolutely.
A lot of beef. You wondered where it is. There it is.
There's your winners, right?
Quake and Typhoon.
Gorilla
odds
easily.
On favorites in this
yes,
one.
Yes, I would say so, definitely. If size and
from
strength
Cuba, Mexico,
means anything,
Tito Santana.
I would say that Earthquake is definitely a favorite here.
No question.
You know, the secret to a battle royal is not to dump the biggest guy out, not to dump the smallest guy out. When everybody eliminates somebody else, you just stand back, let them do your dirty work, and when no one's looking, boom, he's gone. Get rid of him.
Sucker punch somebody, right?
Well, it has been successful in the past. I don't see why it shouldn't be successful again.
From Canada, weighing 243 pounds, the
Jailbird. There he is.
Sherlock, to you.
Well, I would imagine there'll be quite a few in this battle royal gunning for that particular person.
You know,
made any
I
friends.
Think a lot of guys are going to be gunning for you, Lord Jim. Gunning for Ric Flair.
Yes, him too, absolutely. But he, in my books, is probably odds-on favorite to win this whole
and next,
event.
The tag team combination of Shawn Michaels, Mighty Kennedy, the Rockers.
You're totally against Ric Flair being in a battle royal. You got 19 guys that love to take a cheap shot and say, I threw the real world champion out. To me, it's too dangerous, but it shows you the kind of competitor he is. Why isn't Hulk Hogan in this battle royal?
Just because you're his advisor brain doesn't mean he has to take your advice.
And you tell me why Hulk Hogan is not here in London.
Because he's too smart.
Because he's making movies, the big star.
He's the real champion.
Because he's yellow. He knows Flair's here.
Well, I wouldn't want to be in his shoes.
No, neither would I.
Just,
you know,
this guy just got clobbered by Davey Boy.
You know, quite seriously, Heenan does make a sort of a semi-final point. Ric Flair is in this battle royal. Hulk Hogan is not. That is one thing you must view.
You're right.
Perhaps, your lordship, if the Hulkster were here, Ric Flair would not be.
But who is here? I rest my case. I'm going to get one of those big robes and one of those big curly hairdos like the judges wear.
And do what?
Preside over things, rule on stuff.
Oh. Powerful contenders is Hercules. Hercules is thirsting for a little more
glory.
Of Legion of Doom. I would keep my eye very closely on that particular quarter of the ring.
Now, what's going to be interesting is, let's say the last two are Earthquake and Typhoon. They're going to have to go at it against each other, teammates.
They could easily turn upon each other. That would be very interesting, Bobby.
They got any pride, they'll do it.
Wouldn't everybody love to see this particular most charismatic wrestler win the whole caboodle here?
Boy, has he got a lot of supporters here.
He certainly does. What a fantastic fellow he is. Everybody the world over takes him to their hearts.
Teapot.
It's a samovar.
our pot. You know what he'd do with it? He'd have peanut butter all over it and jelly fingerprints. Be a disgrace.
From Allentown, Pennsylvania, at a combined weight of 546 pounds, the Nasty Boys.
We have Kool-Aid in it.
Here are superb contenders for this particular trophy. I think both these tag team dogs are very likely winners.
Of the South, Jimmy Hurt.
How on earth are we going to keep up? How are we going to keep up with the action in this one? With all these bodies, these 40 arms and legs, your lordship just flying every which direction. What is it?
And from Charlotte,
do you want
North
us
Carolina.
To keep quiet now? It's the real world the champion. It's the real world champion.
Real world champion.
Really?
Rick. So gone off the deep end.
But he does have a point. He made that very transparent earlier.
Everybody
on.
Here in Royal Albert Hall is looking at that man right now. There he is. Get a good look, kids. That's what you want to grow up to be.
Well, if he wanted, he'd probably go out to have a bronze.
There's a little friction already in the ring.
Just Flair walking in the ring's making people nervous.
It is indeed. You're right, Bobby. There's a lot of anticipation. Oh, wow.
Imagine if Camel and Hawk had to go at it against
Hawk
each other.
And Animal.
This is
going to
be
great. Of the Doom.
It's going to be mayhem when that bell finally rings to kick this thing off.
Gorilla, it's a wonder to me that particular ring is bearing all these people. Was it specially reinforced?
Yeah, we talked about that earlier on, your lordship. There was a special reinforcement done.
And England's favorite son, the British Bulldog.
Here comes, this man is the odds-on favorite to be the first to the fourth thrown out. Because he just had a match with the Barbarian. He sustained a bloody nose.
A grueling match.
And a grueling match, yeah.
He really did.
And we quote you on that. Mark that down,
have him laminated in your wall, pal.
And you know, the other thing, Bobby, he's had the least time to recuperate from that very, very grueling match.
Whoa.
Being accompanied by his
all of a sudden got very quiet up here.
And very cold.
The Undertaker!
Man with a black heart, the ominous one.
A hush falls over the Royal Albert Hall.
Oh, this man
I don't
is so
honestly
awesome.
Think, your lordship, he cares whether he wins or not.
How many carcasses he can create. Absolutely, just look at those
eyes. Does the word embalm mean anything to you?
How many body bags will be needed?
19.
You're right, Bobby. Everything has gone deathly quiet in here with his arrival. Even the ring combatants have sort of slowed down.
You know, London's an eerie place anyway with all this rain and stuff.
And the final participant in the Battle Royal from Glasgow, Scotland, Harry Paper!
Oh, listen to this ovation for the home run!
The rowdy one, another Great Britain representative, a man who has brought a lot of hope and courage to the Scots. A superb performer in the ring, a lot of heart, but a lot of skill and finesse.
You're right, Alfred. It takes a lot of ability to get in a battle royal with a miniskirt on.
Will you stop?
What a steely look in Piper's eye.
He's looking right at the world champion, and Blair's saying, come on. There you go.
Whoa!
Did not wait. He ran straight for Ric Flair. He has a bone to pick with him.
Bell's gone, and we're underway in this one.
And what a tremendous tussle this is. Everybody absolutely intent on getting somebody out at the moment. And that looks like, I believe, Flair is actually out.
Did he go over the top rope? I gotta have him. Somebody tell me.
I don't think he went over the top rope.
They would have made an announcement, wouldn't they?
Well, I saw Flair on the floor. I was watching that particular time earthquake.
Well, he's definitely out, but if he was thrown out, we'd have heard about it.
It's over the top rope for elimination. If you go between the ropes, you are entitled to come back.
They're out on the floor fighting. They don't care about winning this one. Piper just wants to hurt that man.
Extracurricular activity, but look at this on the inside. Oh! Hulk come floating down there.
And one of our camera cables wrapped around him.
Bossman's out on the floor. The Mountie's on the floor.
Well, Bossman was looking for Mountie. Mountie was trying to take some sort of refuge outside. In the meantime, look at Paul Glory there, really hammering away. Sags is that not? No, Nobbs is trapped by Bossman.
There's so much going on, Alfred. I don't know what to watch.
Let me do the first man out is the first man who makes a mistake, who's not watching his own back.
He's the first guy that gets the hot shower.
Oh, a tremendous sandwich in the corner there. Earthquake, Typhoon, and they had Tito Santana trapped, and Santana looking terribly dizzy. And what a tremendous mass of humanity fighting and struggling there. This is truly a survivor.
Look at this. Everyone here at the Royal Albert Hall is standing. Everyone's watching this. I don't think they've ever seen anything like this.
And it looks as if Big Boss Man is perilously close to being out.
Undertaker was also perched up there.
And however he did that, Boss Man managed to struggle back in.
Piper and Flair are still going at it.
And Undertaker is struggling too. He's in a lot of trouble.
Hawk and Romer are going at it. Hercules.
It looks as if Hercules is out.
He has been eliminated, no question about it.
He just went to get a chair.
Well, he's out.
He'll be fine. He'll be suspended if he's not careful.
But he wasn't thrown out.
And somebody else just went out. I do believe it was Tornado.
I can't tell.
Texas Tornado is gone.
He's gone, so we've had two eliminated already. One of them a strong favorite, Hercules.
18 to go. They were all strong favorites. It's hard to pick a winner.
It really is, but we can eliminate those two. And look at this, somebody going. No, it's one of the Rockers. Poised there. Shawn Michaels. Perilously close also, but back in again. Piper practically out, but back in.
Oh, whoa. That's over the top, but he did not go to the floor. Not yet, anyway.
And he still hasn't.
He's still hanging on. Oh, there he goes. He's out of there.
Nobbs is out. One of the nasty boys eliminated. And I'm sure that will infuriate his partner, Sags.
A little last-minute wave by the Hot Rod.
The Boss Man's up in the air.
One of the Rockers is gone. And I believe that's Marty Jannetty. Is
doesn't
that right,
matter.
Gorilla?
Doesn't matter.
What do you mean it doesn't matter?
Oh, you lose one rock, you might lose two. It doesn't matter.
And even though four or five have already been eliminated, just look at that, as we said before, mass of humanity still left.
But what I've noticed is the Undertaker has stood in the middle the whole time. He wants to fight. Pound on me, he says. Kick me, hit me. Try to get me out.
Flair backing off from Animal.
Well, Flair's smart. I back up from Animal, too. So he can make a mistake, then he's all Flair's.
One man suffering very much is Gorilla. Oh, Gorilla, look at that Barbarian.
Barbarian is out of there.
Well, I was going to say Glory is really suffering. He's down on his knees, and that's a dangerous place to be inside. You're better off on your knees outside.
Barbarian eliminated by Tito Santana. Now it's starting to get more interesting. Not quite so many bodies. Five have been eliminated.
I believe the Mountie's gone.
Six. Tito Santana out.
Look at Piper. He goes right after Flair. You're going to jump on, but Flair's going to knock you right off, pal.
Whoa.
No, the Mountie has not been eliminated yet. He just took some refuge on the outside, some respite. He's back in. Flair's back in.
Sure, Flair waited till the Hot Rod was captured.
Smart
by
move.
Earthquake.
Smart move, Monsoon. Everybody's slowing things down now. You notice that?
And Typhoon getting an awful shellacking in the corner. And I believe that's Hawk.
He's
eliminated.
Out. He's out.
And there is Sags. Gosh, Sags followed him in short shrift.
Good dropping like flies now.
And one man looking particularly strong at this point is The Undertaker. He's going to be favored to do some good here. Davey Boy Smith, the British Bulldog, trying to get rid of the Mountie.
Look at The Undertaker choking the breath out of the big animal.
Oh, and another one. Did he reach the floor?
No, no, no.
Oh,
he's gone. He's gone.
Was a survival try by Shawn Michaels, but for not.
No, and then up behind Big Boss Man comes the Mountie. And it looks as if Glory and Mountie have got Boss Man where they want him. Oh, Earthquake took an awful, awful hit there.
Somebody hold my jacket.
Oh, you want to get involved?
No, it's just getting hot up here. I'm not getting down there. You think I'm crazy?
Anybody would be crazy who got in there, Bobby. Don't worry.
There.
An Earthquake.
They're still going at it.
He's still staying in there, though. He was my back. Look at this!
Flair!
Oh, just short of being pitched right outside. No!
Duggan's gone.
Oh,
out of
there. Duggan's
gonna be. We have 10 gone and 10 to go.
Halfway point. Halfway point. This could go all night. You realize that?
That was sad to see Hacksaw go out. He went out number 10. He's coming back in with a 2x4. The referee should stop this. That is not right.
Whoa. Come on, ref, stop him.
No.
He's not out. He's not out. Pull it.
No.
He won't do it. He's too big.
Jimmy's trying to push
him.
Oh, my God. That gigantic landslide as Earthquake came off.
To the outside goes Hot Rod along with Ric Flair. And they are just pummeling one another. But I don't think either one of them.
They don't know it's a battle royal. They're just going at it.
It's a war.
Look at those lefts that Hot Rod hit Flair with. And Flair down and looking in a lot of trouble right at this particular moment.
Oh, look at that. Hot Rod dipped the shoulder.
What do you say?
He's crying right now, Albert.
He didn't say anything.
He can't speak.
He's speechless. You
have to
be right. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. We got 8 men left in there. And we may just have 7 in just one moment. Bossman has mounted precariously positioned there.
Got stopped from the backside.
Glory ran into him.
You know, it was a smart move on Ric Flair's part to jump over the top. He's figuring, what do I need a teapot for anyway? I can buy all the silver in London. Good move.
The British Bulldog trying to put Typhoon out. A little bit of help from Typhoon by the Mountie.
Look at Piper.
What are we
right
on
right after The Undertaker.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 left.
We still have 8. And look at Piper's trying to get rid of The Undertaker.
Whoa.
Didn't quite manage it.
What a headbutt by The Undertaker on Hot Rod.
And Glory is still in there.
The matter.
Up.
Whoa.
I spoke too soon. He's gone.
The jerk is out.
An animal making concerted effort.
Oh.
He's gone.
Animal's gone.
Oh, my word. There's only 6 left.
Calculated error.
Is it even? It's 6-6.
Well, we have
3-3.
British Bulldog, we have the Mountie, The Undertaker, Roddy Piper, Big Boss Man, and Typhoon.
There are no teams in this one, Brian.
There's no teams, not... Well, certainly not now.
Piper charged The Undertaker. He's got to be nuts.
The British Bulldog, the Mountie, who looks as if he's in a lot of trouble, and very fresh-looking Typhoon.
Here's the advantage right here. Jimmy Hart is the manager of Typhoon and the Mountie. That's what's going to take the importance right here.
That could be the catalyst for their success, Bobby. You're absolutely right.
Or Jimmy, their failure.
Sure. And outside, there's still a little extracurricular activity, and they should be very careful. They can easily be suspended. War plans going on here, Gorilla, inside the ring.
Hot Rod a little bit reluctant about leaving. In the meantime, it's
Jimmy's doing it. Jimmy's putting out the game plan. The quarterback of the Jimmy Hart organization is calling the shots. taking up the middle, taking around left end, but score. That's all he's thinking of.
Well, Jimmy Hart, very shrewd. He gives excellent advice. He's a great manager.
That's real football talk for the benefit of you people here.
And here's a part of his plan. But that doesn't seem to be working. How can Jimmy run?
Well, I think he wanted to make it one-on-one to give Typhoon another extra added advantage. But that didn't work.
This is going to be interesting.
Oh, what a shot by Big Boss Man Mountie. Look at him. He's absolutely helpless. How's he
standing there?
Davey Boy down. He doesn't look too good either. The fresh man in there right this moment is Big Boss Man.
Whoa!
Oh,
and these guys have been in since the onset.
Oh, look at Typhoon. He's getting all his wind back. He's been taking it easy. He's been relaxing.
That's underneath. That one.
Oh!
He deserved that.
Oh, my goodness. He sunk. Mouth of the South.
Whoa, 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 whoa. Boss Man's gone.
Nice leverage move by the Mountie.
Typhoon hanging in.
Things don't look good now for Davey.
It's Jimmy Hart. Jimmy Hart's organization will take Davey Boy Smith, the British Bulldog, out single-handedly.
And look at this. The sneaky Mountie is just leaving Typhoon and the British Bulldog to account for each other.
He's
taking it very easy.
He's getting back. Look at the crowd is behind the Bulldog. Every eye at the Royal Albert Hall is focused on the Bulldog. The last thing they want is to see their boy, their neighbor, their countryman dumped at the hands of the Jimmy Hart organization.
Well, people do not look good right now for Davey Boy.
No, they don't.
Oh! Oh, look at that, a crushed jab, but crushed the jailbird instead, and Davey Boy is going crazy.
But Davey, he won't
Boy
be able to do it.
With a great resurgence of energy and strength and power, a lot of speed.
No, he can't do it.
Come on, Davey Boy.
He's
you
strong,
can
he's
do
not
it.
That strong.
Look at the power.
Shut up, Alfred.
Behind you, Davey Boy, behind.
Nail him.
So close.
Listen to the crowd. You can hear a pin drop.
That certainly quietened them. You're right, Bobby.
Boy, it took the wind out of them all.
10,000 people sat down.
Oh, look at this.
Or like this.
Oh, the section in the ranks.
No, he's firing them up. He's firing them up. He's just waking Typhoon up.
Davey Boy, I believe, is due to be dumped right now.
Listen to the people. They are quiet.
Getting it from the front and the back.
Come on, Davey. Watch him.
Set him up here for a double slingshot. Double clothesline.
You want to hear quiet? When he hits the floor, you wait and hear how quiet it's going to be.
Davey, move.
Well, just finished a match not too long ago. Actually, minutes ago, a tough match against Barbarian. How much can one guy put out, Alfred?
Not just a tough match, a grueling match. But he's still in there, and we're hoping and hoping for the best. Duck him!
Great stuff,
stay there!
Turn around, Typhoon!
Take some respite, Davey. Get out of the ring.
Typhoon, now sit
slide
down.
Under. Take a little refuge on the outside.
Sit down, Typhoon. He can't pick you up off that mat. Sit
down.
And
they're on their feet again here.
Sit down.
Everybody.
Everyone standing. We started with 20. We're down to 2. Everyone is on their feet.
And one is the British Bulldog.
Standing drop kick.
Stop, Davey.
Don't get up. He can't pick you up if you don't get up.
Keep after him, Davey Boy. Don't give him any breathing space.
Nice reversal by Typhoon.
Oh!
Nails him with an avalanche in the corner.
It's quiet here again.
What a battle royal.
Oh, gosh.
People are starting to make their way to the door. They know
not
Davey Boy's had it. Davey's waving to the referee. I quit. I've
he
had
did
enough.
Not.
Davey Boy!
Oh!
Here is absolutely overwhelming. Davey Boy, the British Bulldog, you pulled it off. Ah, that's tremendous.
Wait a minute. What's this? Earthquake's in the ring.
This is awful.
Jimmy Hart's in the ring.
Oh, this is Davey Boy's moment of glory in front of his own people. His own island. That's a terrible travesty.
In front of all his people. It's good. What a short bit of success he had.
That's terrible. This should never, ever be allowed. The referees, they've got to bring somebody else in or do something about this. this.
No, it's over.
Davey boy, get up, Davey, get up.
Let's get some assistance down there and get it down there.
Goodbye, Davey. You stay there.
Nice move. He got out of
there. Stay there, Davey.
Call Davey 911 number here in London. They better call for help from Sonny. They're not done with him
yet. They're not finished yet.
Oh, this is terrible. Davey won this match. Why do they have to do this to him?
Oh, look. It's Andre the Giant.
The eighth wonder of the world.
Oh, Andre, all 550 pounds. Just recovered from a knee operation, but the moving. Miss doesn't stop him.
And he's moving pretty good.
Wow!
Oh.
Get out of there! Get out of there! Oh!
Davey boy, don't worry about him. Get back in. Good stuff, Davey.
Out of nowhere! Look at him run like scared rabbits.
This is the greatest battle I've ever seen. Started with 20 men, 20 of the World Wrestling Federation's toughest men, and it boils down to that. The homeboy comes home, the winner, British Bulldog Davey Boy. I can't believe this monster.
Check it out, indeed, they might be loose, but inside he feels just great. What a victory here at Royal Albert Hall for that man right there, the British Bulldog, Davey Boy Smith. Alfred, you must be proud.
Oh, I'm so proud. The silver samovar, the royal samovar on the trophy. How fitting, how very apt that this man should come home where his campaign solo in the United States and in all quarters of the world. And yet here in London, he's before his own people. How appropriate.
Well, Bulldog, you better give that teapot to Andre the Giant because he saved your life.
Davey Boy has a flag. They love him.
Wrapping himself in his country's flag.
And